Your soil is the most important asset on your farm. It's more important than your tractor, it's more important than your harvester, it's more important than the shed, it's even more important than your fishing boat.
More important than my fishing boat? Come off the grass.
Soil health is everything. If you haven't got healthy soil, you haven't got healthy waterways, you haven't got healthy reef, you haven't got healthy produce. So it means a lot to me.
Just like your other assets on the farm, you've got to keep your soil in working order, in good condition, for it to do a job for you and grow healthy, productive crops and pastures. So your soil has three main parts to it. It has soil biology, soil chemistry, and the physical structure, or what we call the physical side of your soils. Those three parts need to be in reasonable balance for the soil to be in working order or healthy. The key parts to your soil biology story are that having enough microbes and diversity in soil organisms and plant root volume in my soil to provide my soil with a good living community. The key soil chemistry parts of soils up here in the wet tropics include things like acidity, exchangeable aluminium, and in some soils sodium, and the calcium magnesium ratio can also be really important. And the key physical part of the soil is having a soil with good tilth and structure. So you don't want a soil that looks like Romano cheese or a concrete block. You want a soil that looks like cottage cheese and is nice and friable. So those three things, the chemistry, the biology, and the physical part of my soil, need to be in balance. This is what we mean by soil health. When you have a healthy topsoil, it gives your paddock and your crop and your farm enterprise real benefits. One of the first things it does is it really improves the efficiency of your fertiliser and nutrient management. A healthy soil cycles its nutrients and stores them really efficiently. The second real benefit that a healthy soil structure gives your soil is good aeration, good water infiltration, and good moisture management. Particularly here in the wet tropics, one of the challenges is flooding and excessive water at times. And having a good structure in your soil helps you bounce back from those flooding events faster. Another key benefit is that you tend to minimise your pest and disease issues in the crops. A final benefit is you get less runoff of sediment from your place. This can really help with the wider catchment and environmental health up here in the wet tropics and our neighbour, the Barrier Reef. So if you want to learn more about soil health and how to manage it and improve it on your place, get in touch with one of your local extension staffs, contact Terrain NRM, or follow the links for more information.